By the way, I will embarrass Mr. Bhatia. Can I call you Mr. Bhatia? Gaurav.
Gaurav is fine.
Gaurav, it's Gaurav's birthday, please. So please wish him a very happy birthday. And you know, I hope you have a good year in personal and professional life. I'm sure you will have. So today we have a panel of people. Some I met for the first time. I've seen them on TV. And three of them I've met. Two of them. All of them is somebody I look up to and I take advice from time to time. In the last 17 years of Session-8, and he's kind enough to spare his time to be with us. So this panel really doesn't need an introduction, but Shri Alok Mehta is a Padmashree. He's edited almost every major newspaper in the country and is very celebrated. He's written books and he's made himself relevant after working for almost 50 years in India. So for any longer panel, you know, that's the most important quality I admire in Alok. He was also part of a jury of the 11th Session-8 New Broadcast Awards, his third or fourth time on the jury, maybe fifth time on the jury. He'll be among the only two people we've repeated every year for being in balance in front of people. Ms. Shama, Mohamed, she's a spokesperson of the Congress. You see her on television. I believe in serendipity, so she was coming here and I was watching a show on which she was there yesterday. She was around in the show debating the attacks in the street. So Ms. Mohamed, welcome. Shall I call you Shama? Then I call you Ms. Mohamed. Thank you very much for that. Ghanshyam, I got to know Ghanshyam for the last few months. I saw him on television, he's the spokesperson for the Congress Party. And as Ravish alluded to, Samajwadi Party. Maybe I'm
futuristic. We don't want any
defection. Okay, no. You clearly don't want it, Gaurav. Yeah. And he's an educated entrepreneur. So started his course in Harvard, he started in IIM, and education is a domain that gives him his bread and butter, and his mission is to change Indian politics. So we have Ghanshyam, and last but not the least, we have somebody who you've seen a lot of times in television. He's been kind enough to make time on his birthday to be here. Mr. Gaurav Bhatia is a lawyer by profession, and he's one of the most forceful voices on television, and sometimes very convincing too. So, thank you for being our panelists. Let me start. This panel is called Do Spokesperson Live in Eco Chambers? Do Spokesperson Live in Eco Chambers? Yeah, we can start with anyone.
No, they don't.
Where do they live?
They live in the middle of a lot of information, a lot of ideas, a lot of feedback continuously, and a lot of criticism together.
Okay. If we had to do facts versus rhetoric, if there was 5 marks for facts and 5 for rhetoric, I want to be honest, at least today here, it's not on television, you don't have to take a part in life. How much marks would you give on facts and how much on rhetoric?
I believe that it's about articulating your point of view in a way that you communicate the facts. I don't think rhetoric figures in that articulation. Rhetoric.
There is
in my opinion, in TV studios, even if you are facing it from the other side.
Okay. Gaurav, coming to you. You know, honesty versus party line, what is more important? Sorry? Honesty versus party line.
Yeah. Thank you for giving me this opportunity of being here. And I must say that being a spokesperson is not an easy thing. And why do I say that? I say that because, you know, when you speak as a spokesperson, you don't cease to be an Indian first. Second, you represent the party and you are the voice of the party. So you have a very onerous task of ensuring that you speak for the nation, but you are also speaking for the party. And last, but not the least, your own conviction in something that you are saying. I think balancing that itself is an art that spokespersons master, and we must give it to them that, you know, sometimes tough questions are posed. That is the time you have to ask. I'll give you another example. I'm a lawyer also. So when I speak for my party, I'll always speak for my nation, and I will also speak something which is legally correct and which is in line with the Constitution. I cannot say something which is not in line with the Constitution. And I must say that, you know, it's not rhetorics. Yes, there is a presentation. you make it interesting for the viewer, because the viewer has to also enjoy what you're saying, then it has to be backed with data. And most importantly, every word that you say, you should be first convinced about it. Now, there is a problem. The problem is sometimes your own thoughts are not in sync with what you are representing.
Sure.
So what do you do? I would say that because your responsibility is also towards your country, society, there are two things you can do. First, internally within the organization, and I've done it in the past, and I think it requires courage to speak within the organization that you serve and you tell them that this is my viewpoint. Either they are able to convince you or you convince them. And if nothing happens, so there are occasions I must share, when you decide that you know there are better suited individuals within the organization who will represent. And why? Because they are convinced with the idea. So I think this is the balancing act that a spokesperson does. And you also learn, like a lawyer, the spokesperson should also know, sometimes it is more important to not say things than to say things. So you should be aware of that also as a spokesperson.
I'm sure you walked the talk. And coming to Shama, I was happy to see on the last panel, we have three women and three men. At least we have one woman, so I'm very happy. Shama, you know, Gaurav talked about representing the nation, talking factually right, and then propagating the cause that you're there for. Isn't that a very tough to do all three things? And how do you do it? You know, it's easy for Gaurav to stay there, but it's more difficult to do in reality.
Couple of points. One I would like to say first, which you did not mention, is that I'm a dentist by profession. And it is not being a spokesperson.
Now I know why Dr. Patra was fighting yesterday on the show.
It's not, you know, when you have to be out there, they think that the spokesperson, like Ghanshyam was saying, that it is not something we just make up, or like him, I do not believe in that way. We have to believe what we are going to say out there. It's a tough job. And I just recall Ravishi had said that, you know, what do spokespersons do? They just come in and they have to go. No. We have to do a lot of research, because we are the face of the party everywhere on television. When you see that, you know that whatever this person says is the party line. So we have to go on facts. And another very important point is, I have been sent on GDP debates, I've been sent on economy, and that day I keep researching for 2 to 3 hours because I do not want to go on facts, wrong on facts. And sometimes on legal issues I've been sent, and I think it is right, because as a dentist, I look at the legal issue as a layman, and I try to convince my point of view to the layman the way I see it, and not like Gaurav would see it as a lawyer. He would see it in a different manner. So that is the important part. And it is important that we believe in a line which is factual, but not made up, and sit on facts and not rhetoric, and continue to be honest to our country, the people out there, and you know, never go wrong, not echoing, be on the ground reality. That is important.
Aloji, you know, you've been in journalism for 50 years. You were there when newspapers were prime, the TV started, and I said, every night you're on TV debate. You're an editor, expert, and somebody who has a perspective. And dare I say, I'm not saying Gaurav doesn't have a perspective, Ghanshyam doesn't have a perspective, Shama doesn't have a perspective, but by your years, long years, 50 years, having seen various parties, various people, you have a certain background, perspective. I want you to be honest here. I know you are a very diplomatic person and balanced person. Yeah, but you balance, okay. Do you really believe what they're saying these days? That they balance the nation's interests, the facts, and their parties? I mean, do really spokesperson want to be on the spoke? Do that? Do they come across of that? Does the House believe the spokesperson do that? How many of you believe that the spokesperson are only about to be shouting and getting the most hear a voice, and second is taking the party point of view. Let's see how many of you believe that. And how many of you believe they are balanced and they don't live in echo chambers and they are believable? Less believe that. Okay, some are not decided. But I want your view.
I think it's better they decide. From the viewers and the leaders who build our television, they are the real judge, I think. And basically, what I feel that what they speak will depend on their leadership. How the head of the media cell or the party general secretary. Normally, what I feel because of my experience and sorry to share with friends, that when you are committed with ideology, not only research, but if you depend on the ideology, if you are committed to the communist ideology, if you read Nehru or Indira Gandhi, or when you read Dhyan Bhatia, read Lohia, or even
JP.
So I think it, always it happens earlier days, because I don't know if Shamaji, have you remember Shikant Varma? Have you read something about him?
No,
I have
to be honest. I'm not going to.
That's a good start.
And Gaurav, have you met or heard something about J.P. Mathurji, BJP? I think Samajwadi Mulayam Singh Yadav himself was a spokesman or the most active leader. So that's why I feel in the Congress party, and Shrikant Varma, just for one background, Shrikant Varma was in the Congress days from Mrs. Gandhi days, he was the spokesman, he was a journalist. That's why I'm comparing nowadays. He was socialist basically. Joined Congress, working, and even when he was very close to Mrs. Gandhi, he used to go to his place, to home in Rajendranagar, in Barsati. But he used to write in Dinman criticizing Congress. I still feel there should be such democratic parties. They should encourage their people, sometimes well, they disagree. And they also encourage them. Okay, you disagree, sometimes when you go. And stick on your point, your ideology, your secularism or Hindutva or socialism for the community, for caste, for religion. Okay, you come on for those issues. But you speak something if you feel disagree. Nowadays what's happening? Yashwant Sinha is saying it's a different case. Because time changed and now because he shifted to some for other reasons, that's why he decided. But he's not the party line. He's not speaking what he should. What he used to get from those people whom he is criticizing, either business houses or the party leadership. So that's why this is the comparison nowadays what is happening. I think the spokesman, they are doing very good, Ghanshyam will not, because he is here, just now Ravishji, I think Ravishji is here or I think he is there.
He is in the hotel, he's not there.
But I disagree with him. If I can write about income tax, Ravishji can talk about it, why can't? Ghanshyam is an educated person, it is a background, Shamaji, she speaks something. She can also talk about income tax, maybe. I am also not expert on income, what are you talking about? Because that's why he is running the business world also. But sometimes, if you are prepared, you can talk on different issues, but one should be prepared on this point, and rather than just, I want to do it before other discussion. Nowadays, what is happening? Inside, I know, because all old friends, the parties in different parties. You must have my few friends was been going. When I used to go in earlier days, people say, oh, Sonia Gandhi ne paisa bhej diya hoga. Ab yadi main jata hu to kahenge nahi, Modi ji ne tarikh hai janu kar diya hai. Yadi main Akhilesh ji ki tarikh kar dunga, to usse pata nahi kya ho gaya. Ki kahan hai aise wo kar rahe. To problem ye hai ki yadi aap sach bolenge, jaisa aapne kaha, to logon ko kadwa bhi lagta hai, kuch logon ko lagta hai ki aap ko ek tarfa ho. To spokesman aur even jaisa aap Ravish keh rahe the, because of one side, you say that you have to do this, you have to do this, you have to do this. This is our problem in India. This is what we want to force, what we want to listen. We should try to do what people want to listen.
You have to carry it with you. That's what you have to say. Now, what are the good lawyers? If you mic set, can you get two more mic set? Why do you, if you look at the number of spokespersons over the last 15 years, 20 years, most of the spokespersons, 40% of them, are lawyers. Is there a certain quality that lawyers have that makes them a spokesperson?
I would say that it's a privilege that a lawyer has, and you must have seen that even during the field study, lawyers led from the front. And with utmost respect to other professionals as well, but I think when you use your faculties, especially intellectual faculties, day in, day out, and you have the most brilliant judges in the Honorable Supreme Court, and you put forward a point and you are rebutted immediately, I think it sharpens your debating skills as well. And therefore, I think it's good for Indian politics that we have people like Mr. Jaitley on one side and Mr. P. Chidambaram and Kapil Sibal on the other side. It creates the right kind of balance. And both are so convincing, I must say, that if you hear Mr. Jaitley, you will say, yes, he's probably right.
Very
and the moment the other side will speak, you will be convinced with what they are saying. So I think it is good for democracy that we have such brilliant minds, and I think I am also learning from them. But I think professionals, people who are educated, who have, you know, this sense of actually serving our country, who are dedicated, should come forward. And politics should not remain an abuse for the common man. They should not feel neta hai, matlab kuch to garbad ho gaya. I think, you know, it is time that our country deserves better leader, people who are here to serve, people who are not here to take from the country. But I have a point to make, sir, if you allow me. You know, it's not only about spokespersons. I have been debating for the last 8 years now, virtually on every channel, and there's two things I like to also, you know, share with the audience here. It's very important. The anchors and the media houses have a very important role to play. You know where the problem lies, and I'll give you two, three small examples. The choice of panels. The triple talaq verdict comes, the Honorable Supreme Court says that it is bad, it is unconstitutional, it is against the spirit of gender equality. We see in a debate, and with all our political differences, debate we see probably somebody who has a background who will say, कि नहीं जो ये महिला है ना इनको घर में होना चाहिए बाहर नहीं हमारे घर में हस्तक्षेप क्यों कर रहे हैं एंड ऑन द अदर साइड देयर पीपल लाइक शमा देयर पीपल लाइक घनश्याम एंड वेरी एजुकेटेड पीपल हु अंडरस्टैंड द वैल्यू सिस्टम ऑफ आवर कंट्री हाउ डू यू एक्सपेक्ट दीज पीपल हु आर ब्राइट टू अंडरस्टैंड टू डिबेट दिस इशू विद अ पर्सन हु डजंट इवन अंडरस्टैंड द स्पिरिट ऑफ आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन सेकंड When you make a valid point and when you are well prepared, because the audience wants that. They want to hear an educated discussion on facts, on realities of life, not just words, you know, which have no meaning. Then there is suddenly a rebuttal from the other panelists who will hit you below the belt, right. Who will become personal, who will get your family in between, who will even try to touch you maybe. You know, the sad part is I think any honorable anchor should immediately intervene without a second wait for the dignity of the guest that he's called, for the respect for the audience. You know what I have noticed? If they throw the jacket, they will wait for 2-3 minutes first. Let the, you know, standing match, shouting match continue, and then suddenly they will come. They will equate the two and they'll say, ये बहुत गलत हुआ है, इसको हम नहीं बर्दाश्त करेंगे. भाई साहब, बहन जी, ये बर्दाश्त नहीं करेंगे तो पहले सेकंड में क्यों नहीं आपने कहा हमारे चैनल से आप जाइए यहाँ पे शिष्टाचार की बहस होती है यहाँ पे गाली गलौज की बहस नहीं होती आई थिंक चैनल्स आल्सो नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट यू आर केटरिंग टू यू आर केटरिंग टू सच अ वास्ट ऑडियंस नॉट अ सिंगल वर्ड व्हिच इज नॉट इन द स्पिरिट ऑफ डिस्कशन शुड बी यू नो सेड ऑन अ नेशनल प्लेटफॉर्म और अ स्टेट प्लेटफॉर्म
संजय वांट टू रिस्पोंड संजय वांट टू कंप्लीट
आई थिंक एज वी लुक एट What spokespersons do? You have to look at the undercurrents of politics. I carry the newspaper of today, and on page 3, we see a minister of the current government says fake news distortion says Smriti Rani on unemployment data. This is on NSSO report. So you have Central Statistics Commission. Mr. Mohamed, who has 36 years of experience in that, his report is being presented as fake news. Then we have the situation, and it's important to look at the situation that's playing out in the country. I've got these 5 words. You have a situation where news plays out that the BJP national president says that we can get away with whatever we spread. We have a situation where we have to fact check the prime minister. So that is, and then we have an atmosphere where baat ka badangar, baat se bada jata hai. What you said, when you said, I want to say honestly about my experience in last 2 years. I saw a phase which is now passing. I just saw a phase where a bunch of new fresh spokespersons came with a mindset ki main hamari party ka social media se bahut powerful hai. Main aisa kya kehne, kis andaaz se kehne, kisko kehne, ki wo raato raat viral ho jaye aur raato raat bahut bada neta ban jaye. We have to realize that technology has come in a way that it will look at your videos and eventually give a connection rating. At Harvard, I came across a class where they did a rating of a CEO versus analyst stock, where they said that the software tells whether the CEO is saying a truth or not, based on punctuations, based on the phrasing. In due course, whatever we say on television, technology will be able to analyze some of this and give us a conviction score, give us a fact score. So we have to understand that we are getting public records. It is not going to be just the issue of today. Tomorrow, if Gaurav, I, Shama, every one of us stay and expand our work in public life, we will also be measured about on the footage that we have created, on our point of views on various issues, and whether they stand the test of technology, time and truth.
I want to add to that, today's topic is echo chamber. Spokespersons, like, and you know, the biggest echo chamber right now is the government of the day. You know, they are living in an echo chamber, in a utopian world, in which they think, I mean, like, for example, the difference the minister says last week, there has been no terrorist attack after 2014. It's on record. You know, so when you create certain things like that, when you do not, you say there is this CMI report where there is 6% unemployment. And you say that's wrong. Just now we said NSO report about again unemployment, that is wrong. NSE came out with the GDP, that is wrong. So what we as spokespersons or as a person from the Congress party is that if there is a problem, if there are farmer suicide, there is not been NCRB report after 2016. We do not have a report. We do not know how many farmers have committed suicide. So what I'm trying to say is, Gaurav, at the end, our vichardhara will be alert, even for Ghanshyam, but we are all Indians. And what we need to do right now is there is a situation. If there is a problem with the GDP, let's sort it out. If there is a problem with farmer suicide, let's sort it out. But why hide the facts? Why keep quiet? If there is, you know, let's go out there and say there are issues, we need to solve it, and that's what we can't, as a country or as a ruling party, live in an echo chamber which is far away from the people. We need to address this ground reality, what is happening right now in this country, and come out with what we can do. I mean, we cannot say that there are not going to be any terrorist attacks. There will be, and if there is one, we need to discuss. Like Ravishi had said, we need to question. We understand that Pakistan has done it. It's behind it. We know that. But we also need to find out why there has been a certain intelligence failure. We need heads rolling. Like, when 2611 happened, in our time, when UP was heads rolled, you know, the Home Minister, Mr. Padmashree, I'm saying even tomorrow, if it's our party, we shouldn't be in this sort of echo chamber, you know, all of us, where we have to see the ground reality and see to it that we work for the Indians out there. Let's be truthful to them, yeah, as even TV channels or anyone else.
And Gaurav, just look back at Gaurav.
So the opportunity, I believe, is not really in the Kutu Mayamaya. When you ask that question to the audience, that's not my problem. See, the thing is that I am not there in politics. Gaurav is not there, Shama is not there to achieve a certain rating. I think that history has never measured a guy or a woman or a man, a leader, who spoke the most number of words. So clearly it's not about rating for us, but one thing, where there is an opportunity in the wake of all this, and time what Ravishji said, that when something like this plays out, it's also an opportunity for Gaurav or for me to look at innovative, creative ways for road ahead. Once we identify the problem that we face, the problem that we have faced in opposition is that sometimes agreeing on the problem itself is a problem.
Beautiful. Agreeing on a problem, defining what is you say, you know, Shama, let me say, every country across the world today, right-wing forces are taking over. The leaders of those countries have made it fashionable to criticize the press. You know, look at Donald Trump, constantly negative network, you know, Clinton News Network, constantly waging a war against the press and bringing down the credibility of the press. And you look at Turkey, you look at America. So I don't think the trend is just confined to any one country, right? So in that, I think when you talk of fake news, the media people are the affected party.
But can I add to that? Yeah. That when it happened in the US, a CNN reporter was thrown out from the press conference. He was not allowed to speak. Every channel supported that reporter. And the case went to court and he could come back to the press conference. So that is what I'm trying to say is, we have to be independent. We have to, yes, you can have a right to the view, you can have a left view, we have the right to dissent. Supreme Court said if we do not have the right to dissent, it's going to be like a pressure cooker which is going to explode. For a democracy to sustain, to go forward, it is very imperative that we have the right to dissent.
Totally. But I'm saying that we know that every party, whether it's the Congress party, whether it's the Sabha in UP, whether it's the BJP now in power, they make it a point to allude to the erosion of credibility. Whether it's eroding or not, we know how much. But not everything that the media does is wrong. Not everything is because of a certain viewpoint. And I keep saying the media people haven't come from mass leaders. We are normal people. Even Ravishi told me I'm normal. You heard it. For the first time, we have the same red blood like everybody else. We haven't come from Mars, Venus, some other satellite, right? So, the point I'm trying to make, the government of the day will make sure that they have to look media and adversary for them, right? So, we are working that atmosphere. How do we in that atmosphere? People like Bhatia, people like you, people like Tiwari, really speak the truth within the boundaries that they operate in the country.
I would say that I am reminded of the famous lines of Gandhi, Evelyn Beatrice, if I am not wrong. You may disagree with me, but I will give my life for your right to disagree. And that is democracy.
Beautiful.
And I must say that, yes, my friend Ghanshyam is absolutely right. Today's discussion is not about the regular issues that we discuss every day on prime time. Therefore, I am not getting into the politics of it. Employment data, all these numbers, how youths have been empowered, we do it day in, day out. Today's discussion is on a different tangent, and I would like to shed some light on my viewpoint. He said it right. He said, you wouldn't be remembered by the number of words you speak. Same way he was showing Indian Express. Do you know the bravest piece of journalism done by Indian Express itself during an emergency? There were no words on the front page. It was blank. That was the bravest piece of journalism as a mark of protest. Why would you do? Second, the problem starts when, see, anchor's job is to ask the most difficult questions to me, to other parties as well. It's good to take sides. You may have an opinion. But it can't be that a journalist also becomes pro-party. And I've seen
journalists are pro-party.
I will not give you any names because I am on the principle, I am not on the person. I think my message to the audience is very loud and clear. What I am trying to say is that in journalism, one day you could be hammering one party, but the other day, if the opposition is wrong, you may be asking the toughest questions from the opposition. That is your job, that is your duty. Right. And what I am not saying for all journalists, there are very good journalists in our country. And any institution would only survive on the strength of good individuals. But I am only saying that a journalist cannot afford the risk of being aligning with any party. When a journalist is dutifully questioning the Prime Minister for a 1 hour, 40 minute interview and head of another party without making it political calls that journalist liable, I think that is not justified. Because you are taking away from the hard
work with the Prime Minister.
What I, Annurag, want to do, that this is a discussion where we should leave the room with some broader thoughts, not just party line, and therefore it's not about Congress or BJP or any other party. These are all things that journalists should be asking. I wish I was one.
But
you know,
on the contrary, journalists have stand up. The curve is going,
Would you not agree, and would the audience not agree, that say on one day, if a party has done wrong, journalist is questioning that party, the very next day the opposition might have done something wrong. So you have to question the opposition. But what has happened, that you know, especially some online media, if you see, they have never covered a story on the other side of the fence. I think is a dangerous thing. Second, journalists, while they are questioning us in debates also, journalists have to remember their job is to ask questions. You can't become a better spokesperson than the spokesperson of the party.
I love that.
So leave that to us. We are capable individuals all across party lines, and we will respond with all the strength, honesty that we have. And journalists should do their job of asking tough questions to us.
आज ही बस मौसम ऐसा हो गया है. प्रॉब्लम ये है कि बीते दिनों में शुरू में कहा था मैं पावर केयर कर दूँ, यदि उनको जो उनके हेड हैं यदि कहें कि आप जाकर कहिए जर्नलिस्ट को देखिए इसका मुंह बंद कर देना है, वहाँ जाकर कहना है तुम पुरानी जात के हो या तुम पुराने अखबार के हो, तुम्हारा मालिक है इसलिए तुम ऐसा कर रहे हो. प्रॉब्लम स्टार्ट हियर बिकॉज वेन यू ब्लेम जर्नलिस्ट एंड डिपेंडिंग ऑन योर कंसेंट बिकॉज द प्रॉब्लम इज व्हेन यू से इवन रवीश से समथिंग इज नो रॉन्ग योर बायस योर बिकॉज ऑफ योर party belong, which party belong, problem here is that. मुझे जो मालूम है हुआ यही है कि आप लोगों के वहाँ पर कहा गया, बाकायदा इस पोस्ट में नहीं मुझे बताया कि देखिए हमें कहा गया कि ऐसा कहें, मैं आपको बिल्कुल नहीं कहना चाहता मैं क्या करूँ, आपने हमें बनाया है. उसके बाद भी उसकी हमें बार बार इंस्ट्रक्शन मोबाइल से दिए जाते हैं कि आप जाके गाली दो, वहीं से शुरू होता है बुराई. व्हाई नॉट द लीडरशिप दे थिंक दैट इट टू अब्यूज जर्नलिस्ट. I remember I went to number of UP Singh. UP Singh days, what happened? At that time also there were journalists in the party with the UP Singh on proposed issue. Other friends were with the
Congress
or Rajiv. They used to feel something else different. So it always happened. But in Mulayam Singh days, Allah won, you remember? But what happened when the editors came, Ajit Bhattacharya, Indra Malhotra and myself, we went to Lucknow. उन्होंने सामने रख दिया कि देखिए ये चिट्ठी है, वो शुगर मिल के लिए मांग रहे थे, आप बताइए ना झगड़ा तो इस बात पर है, अखबार से असली झगड़ा तो इस बात पर है, चार चिट्ठियाँ हैं ये मांगते हैं. तो प्रॉब्लम एंड नाउ इज नॉट टूडे, इन टाटा वॉज इन स्टेट्स में देर वॉज ए प्रॉब्लम फ्रॉम मिसेज गांधी इवन बिफोर इमरजेंसी. मिस्टर गोयल कैन रीड दी बी जी वर्गीज बायोग्राफी अटल बिहारी, उन्होंने खुद जो लिखा है उसमें क्या कहा है बताया कि कैसे कैसे प्रेशर हुआ, अरुण छोड़ी को किस तरह रामनाथ गोयलका ने निकाला फिर रखा, वॉट अरुण छोड़ी वॉज डूइंग एट दैट टाइम. So the problem is people, our friends in the journalism or the politics, they don't know how much pressure. I was in Bihar, Patna. Abhi Ravi ji itna keh rahe the, gaali dete. Rajan Mathur was the anchor, Navbharat Times, jab terrorism shuru hua. 250 chitthiyan roz aati thi. Even when I was not anchor, I wrote one thing about the Vishwendu Parishad, those days, 86-85. You know, what happened? Sardar Andre, now he is no more. उन्होंने यही कहा बाकायदा फोन पर दूसरे को कहा भी देखो मैं इसको ट्रक से चलवा दूंगा कि बी एच पी का युवा सपोर्टर युवा राइट हैंड मैन ऑफ लाइफ बात असन दिया. सो वी यूज टू फेस दैट प्रॉब्लम. चारा कारण हमने जब छापा तो प्रेस में आग लगा दिया कि कैरिट वन सिंगल आइटम. नाउ यू से ओ हो खतरा है मेरी जान को, मैं दुनिया को बचाऊंगा, मैं देश को बचाऊंगा, मैं बिहार को बचाऊंगा. व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम जर्नलिस्ट यू शुड बी रेडी. आई ऑलवेज से कि जर्नलिस्ट को तैयार रहना चाहिए, वो बिहार में हो उत्तर प्रदेश में हो नॉर्थ ईस्ट में हो. One should really face challenges. And in spokesmen, they should not be personal against the anchors, and anchors should not be behave like in a manner of the party.
I want to end this conversation with Ravi, but I want to ask, I want to make the Mahal that, by the way, Gaurav ji, you are now Annurag ji, me and Annurag ji. On another
note,
I just want to know. You know, I'm going to ask Gaurav ji, I'm going to ask आपके फेवरेट स्पोक्सपर्सन अपनी पार्टी में कौन है और दूसरी पार्टी में कौन है, और आपके लिए उन्होंने मतलब मुझे अपनी पार्टी में और somebody you admire or like or you know you love listening to him when you're
out. I would say that even when I was in my first five party,
in the Samajwadi party,
yes, there were speakers in other parties that I have admired and I have learned from. I think Arun Jaitley ji.
When you were talking, I was feeling the differences in the way you talk, like Arun ji
talks. That's a huge compliment. I don't know whether I deserve it or not. Very kind of you. But I must say, Arun ji, when he speaks like a statesman.
And with facts.
Second, though he's not the spokesperson, but I think Narendra Modi ji, and I'm not saying it because, you know, he happens to be the Prime Minister or he's the, you know, tallest leader in our country. But I feel Narendra Modi ji has that magnetic oratory skills that he can captivate.
But the spokesperson, the spokesperson.
Then I think Smriti Rani ji. Sudhanshu Trivedi ji is a wonderful spokesperson. A wonderful spokesperson. His grasp on history, his oratory skills, I have learned a lot from him. I will even go, you know, beyond BJP. I want to make a few persons even on the other side.
Clearly not Mr. Badoria.
I'm sorry?
Clearly not Mr. Badoria.
I would say, you know, I would not like to discuss. Yes, but I believe that people I can admire are those who live up to certain standards. You may lose a debate, but never lose your reputation. That's the first principle of the spokesperson. Okay, and therefore I am not referring to his name, but yes, even in the Congress, Dr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi, a lawyer par excellence, a great spokesperson, very, very erudite. Manish Tiwari ji, again, is a wonderful spokesperson. And I must say, you know, when we come to know that this is your fellow panelist from the other party, when you hear these names, you get charged up. Sure. I spent extra half an hour, 1 hour preparing because, you know, I want to live up to the expectations of the audience. And I think it is their energy that brings out the best in us. And ek baat main aap se kahunga, jisme patrikaron ke liye bhi hai, ki mera kehna hai ki hum log sab jude hain. Hum log ki amrikrit kaun judi hai, hum log spokespersons are media hai. Without you, we are not complete. You may be still complete without us. Wo kaha jata tha, akele hi chala tha, jaane pe manzil. Log aate gaye, karwa banta gaya. Aaj kal ulta ho gaya hai. कारवा चलता है और उसके बाद पत्रकार देखता है वो अकेले रह गए और वो क्यों है जो फेयरनेस जर्नलिज्म है ना उसकी बहुत जरूरत है इस देश में एंड मैं समझता हूं कि जो हमारे यंगर जर्नलिस्ट भी आ रहे हैं और सर अलोक जी बैठे हैं उनसे बहुत ज्यादा इनका जो है अनुभव है मैं समझता हूं कि हमारी कंट्री तभी प्रोटेक्टेड रह सकती है जो फोर्थ पिलर ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी बिना डरे निर्भीकता से आप से आप मिला के नेता से पूछे कि ये मेरा सवाल है इस तरह
एवरी पार्टी लीडर एंड ऑल पार्टी लीडर बिलीव दैट बिकॉज मैं कहना चाहूंगा कि हर पार्टी पूरी कोशिश करती है कि ऐसा ना हो और ये आप अंदर अपने आगे बढ़ाए एटलीस्ट
मैं इसमें मैं एक बात जरूर कहूंगा कि देखिए मैं इसमें सहमत नहीं हूँ आप एक चीज जान लीजिए भारतीय जनता पार्टी में मैं रहा हूँ और कम समय में भी मैंने बहुत अंदर से चीजों को देखा है संगठन को समझा है बहुत लोकतांत्रिक तरीके से हमारी पार्टी चलती है और मीडिया को भी हम चाहते हैं कम से कम कि जो है वो अपना कार्य मजबूती से करे मुश्किल सवाल पूछे अमित शाह जी आप बताइए कितने उनके इंटरव्यू हुए जहां मुश्किल से मुश्किल सवाल पूछे गए हैं और उन्होंने उत्तर दिया है और दूसरी बात आपको कोई छुपा नहीं सकता जब तक आप खुद छुपने को तैयार
पिछले 5 सालों में हमारे देश में एक आर्टिफिशियल हिंदू मुस्लिम बहस को जन्म दिया गया है आप गूगल ट्रेंड्स देखें तो इंडिया के फुटप्रिंट पे हिंदू शासन अगर 100 बार दिखाई देता था इंटरनेट पे मुस्लिम शब्द 40 बार दिखाई देता था 30 बार दिखाई देता था आज अगर आप देखिए 5 साल पहले का आंकड़ा है आज अगर आप देखिए तो हमारे ही देश में हिंदू शब्द अगर 50 बार दिखाई देता है तो मुस्लिम शब्द 52 बार दिखाई देते हैं गूगल ट्रेंड बता रहा है मेरे लिए अच्छा होते हैं देख सकते हैं तो मुझे लगता है कि हम जब स्पोक्स पर्सन है तो हमें ये भी देखना पड़ेगा जैसे इको चेंबर के बारे में आपने कहा वो इंडिया इको चेंबर अब वेब व्हाट्सएप सोशल मीडिया नेटवर्क उसका निर्माण कर रहा है क्या हम पत्रकार के रूप में क्या हम पार्टी के रूप में और क्या हम स्पोक्स पर्सन के रूप में उस इको चेंबर को तोड़ करके आप तक एक अच्छी भावना अच्छी सोच और देश के लिए एक अच्छा एजेंडा पहुंचा पाते हैं ये हमारी जिम्मेदारी है और मुझे लगता है कि कोई स्पोक्स पर्सन कितना अच्छा बोलता है या कोई पत्रकार कितना अच्छा बोलता है उससे ज्यादा मुझे लगता है कि उसको आंकना ये चाहिए कि क्या वो इस दौर में खड़े होकर के उसने इस दौर को का मुकाबला किया और आपको समझाता
है कौन आपके फेवरेट है
लोगों का नाम
नहीं।
मैं मानता हूँ कि भारतीय राजनीति में
सबसे प्रबल दौर आ रहा है महिलाओं के प्रतिनिधित्व का, और उसमें मुझे लगता है कि कांग्रेस पार्टी में अनेक महिला स्पोक्सपर्सन बहुत अच्छी हैं, क्षमा है, अभिनेत्री हैं, हमारे पार्टी में जुबी सिंह हैं जो बहुत अच्छे से अपनी बात करती हैं, सुचिता देव हैं जो बहुत अच्छे से बात करती हैं। इन सब के अलावा मुझे लगता है कि योगेंद्र यादव हैं बहुत अच्छे,
जो आपको बिल्कुल अच्छे से देखना नाम है tough love, huh? You have to fit, you have tough love with him. Let's not say you don't like him. Let's say you have tough love.
We have certain, like, if you understand the subject and you feel for it and you know that what you're going to say is right, you can express it. Even for us, Nandiji is in Sujivala is our boss, and during the triple talak time, they wanted to go with the bilingual ex-subjudice matter. They said, no, we are not going to go with subjudice. Why should we stand and appease? We would go with a line that is un-Islamic, it's not in the Holy Quran. Should go. So you can also argue with them and, you know, and say that this is not the right and we need to put our point of view. We should have discussion.
By the way, Mr. Mohamed Khan was part of that jury.
For me, I think in our party is Nandip Sujivala, Abhishek Manu Sindhuji, Kapil Sibhanji, excellent. His party, one of my favorites, who's a gentleman always, who doesn't interrupt, who has got all the facts right.
Yes, I mean, as a spokesperson. And the one that you have tough love with.
And both of them also I admire.
You have tough love with whom?
I think there is a lady in, I can't remember in their party, she's from Mumbai. And she just,
Alok, who's your favorite spokesperson in the Congress?
Favorite to Bada Mushkil, but Manish Bhai, nowadays, Manish Bhai is very balanced. I think when Abhishek Bhai is in the sometimes he's also aggressive, very, very senior person. But I think Manish Bhai is very calm and cool, never fight with the other colleagues from other parties. I think from the other party, and in BJP also, a lot of people are there. Earlier they used to abuse me also, but now it's okay. But I think that's why Samit Patra was so aggressive
better, is less aggressive, is more balanced, always forceful. He continues to, but he's more certain of himself. Maybe it's the long number of men. He's established now. He's, I find him much more pleasant. And I'm not, you know, I find him more sure of himself. And I even these days again, Dr. Patra is also told down. I was watching yesterday when you
were. They
were very toned down. And of course, he tries to, you know, he has a certain way of addressing it, goes down about, makes it trivial as even, you know, so that the intensity comes down. But I think all the spokespersons are getting mature, they're more confident of themselves. So you're seeing a better version of them. That's my view.
You know, I would say Alok ji ne kaha hai ki behtar hone ki zarurat hai, sir, thodi nahi, bahut behtar hone ki zarurat hai. Kyunki aap ye baat maan lijiye ga meri ki jab hum log seasoned logon ko sunte hain kisi bhi party mein, to hum samajhte hain ki abhi bahut rasta baki hai, lamba safar hai aur seekhne ko milega. Aur main arz karunga sabke liye, kyunki people who step out learn. The art of actually being a good spokesperson is not only confined to the studio. Can you come out of the studio with all the heated debate, all your difference of opinion, and still hug each other or shake hands and give thanksgiving? That is the spirit of being a good spokesperson. And इस पे ही मैं कह रहा हूँ, मंजिल मिल ही जाएगी, भटक कर ही सही, वो मरा तो वो है जो घर से निकले ही.
क्या बात है?
आपको बताऊंगा एक जज्बा होता है और ये मेरे साथ होता है और मैं समझता हूँ कई स्पोर्ट्स पर्सन के साथ होता होगा. सुबह ब्रेकफास्ट के बाद कई बार कोर्ट से 4 बजे फ्री होते हैं और 4 से 11 बन जाते हैं विदाउट इवन लंच एंड सीधा डिनर होता है.
इतनी एनर्जी तो लंच
का. यस एंड व्हाई आर आई शेयरिंग दिस, इट्स द पैशन दैट ड्राइव्स यू. इट्स सो ब्यूटीफुल. दूसरी बात, जैसे जो अभी हुआ हमारे 40 भाई शहीद हुए हैं, स्पोर्ट्स पर्सन का काम इसके भी कई बार बड़ा मुश्किल होता है. आप मानेंगे नहीं, कई बार कैमरा ऑन होने जा रहा होता है और आपकी आंखें भी नम होती हैं, लेकिन आप उसको छुपाते हैं. आप भावुक जरूर होते हैं, लेकिन आपको वो बैलेंस मेंटेन करना होता है कि वो बात मजबूती से जाए, कि हमारा विपक्षी भी हमें कमजोर कर सके, समझे, और जो जनता है उसको भी पता चले
बैलेंस के साथ. बैलेंस. Thank you. Please give them a big